Okay, so I'm gonna make a bird bath. I actually need to tilt this paper sideways so I can draw. So I'm gonna make a bird bath. And this is kind of what I was thinking. First, I'm gonna start with the base. I'm gonna throw that on the wheel. And I'm gonna do like a cone kind of base. So this is gonna be. Okay. I'm gonna throw it like this on the wheel. It needs to be. I guess we'll talk about height later. So that's the form I'm gonna throw. And on the inside, if you can imagine, this is the inside of the pot. So I'm gonna make like a little. I'm gonna keep a bottom on it, just like I would a normal pot. And later I'll cut a little hole in it. So then I gotta go to the top portion of it because it's a bird bath. So this is the base, and now the top is going to kind of look like this, but I want maybe a little bit of a decorative, I don't know, so, and it's, okay, you guys catch my drift. So this is, it's like a really shallow bowl, I guess, with like a good size like lip. And I might go around after and scallop the edges. And what I mean by that is if you were looking at it on the side, it would look like this scalloped edge. So I might do that to make it kind of decorative, but I don't know if it's going to be too cutesy for me. We'll see later. So this is my top. I'm gonna throw it on the wheel just like this. It's gonna have a big, you know, because I'm throwing it, it's gonna have all kinds of extra clay, which I will later trim off, and I'm gonna make the foot like this, so it will insert into my base. So that's a concept. I usually do not throw big at all, ever. Like, 8 pounds max. I'm working with 13 pounds estimate because my scale doesn't go that big. So, and this is each, so like here and here, which might be too much clay, but then again, I've never done this before and I don't throw big, so I don't know. We'll see. Also, my wheel head is only 14 inches. So this can only be roughly 14 inches. I can't go much further. So, because I don't have a bat that's big enough to trim the bottom. So I can't go much further than 14 inches. That's kind of one of the reasons I'm trying to do this here. So I can make it a little bit bigger and kind of get away with it. It will sit on the bat. Like, so if this is all upside down, my wheel head would be here. So it will hang over the side, but it will have enough cushion that it will support it. So I have to, it has to be 14 inches. And so I don't really know, I'm throwing this piece first, so I don't really know the height that this needs to be. You would think that it would be a little bit taller than 14 inches. To kind of like compensate, make it look proportional. And I'm gonna eyeball it. So I'm going with 16 inches, but I'm going to eyeball the base so it looks proportioned. Okay, so it's kind of what I think I'm gonna do. We'll see how this goes. I'm gonna throw the bottom on this bat here. This is a bat. This is smaller than my wheel head, so that's why I'm gonna make the base on this so I can just take it off, and then I will work on my wheel head for the top. And like I said, I only have some smaller bats these come in all sizes and they just stick to the wheel head. If I had a bigger one that would extend past my wheel head, then this wouldn't be a problem. But I don't. No, it's okay. So let's start this. It's gonna be cool.
Confident that it's pretty stuck to my wheel. I think I need to speed it up a little bit so I can get it centered. So, too slow, I'm putting pressure on some side, but it's not actually centering. I think it needs to be a little faster. This takes strength. My arms already are tired. Okay.
Actually sink into the earth. So I think what I'm gonna do, and I kept a bottom, and I might cut just a hole in it like I would like a plant pot. So that's my thought process there. This is part two, the top. Again, I gotta keep in mind that I can't be any wider than this. I mean, I could, I mean, I have like a, so I'm working on it.
Cheers to the wish you were here.
93.1, big statement made by the town of York earlier this afternoon. They have made the decision to close the beaches in town.
Really okay. Trying to cut so I have a really nice shape inside.
In large groups, he said.
And basically what I'm going to do is my walls are very thick, so I'm going to pull them up. Because it's going to be very easy to pull them out. Gravity is just going to pull the clay out when I spin it. And I don't want that to happen too early in the process. So I'm going to pull the walls up. And then when I have them at the thickness that I like, I'm going to allow gravity and help the walls kind of flow out. Okay guys, so I have taken my Birdbath top off the wheel and I've covered the top of my base. I don't want that part to get too dry. The top is thinner than the bottom, so it dries at a different rate, and I want to keep the top covered so it all kind of dries at the same speed. So I've taken my top off and I just kind of got it sitting there for a second until I can prep my wheel head. Because I'm gonna start trimming. So there was like a patty of clay stuck to the wheel. I had to take that off, clean it up, so I can flip my little Birdbath top, my little bowl, flip it upside down, and get ready to trim. This is a leather hard stage now. So you can touch it, and it doesn't really wiggle. If you touch it, it doesn't put clay on your hands. It's leather hard. And this is the point where we would start to trim. The bottom's still a little wet, but we're just gonna go ahead and just start this off, and we're just gonna trim anyways. I think it will be okay. So we're gonna turn that into a nice form by trimming all that excess off. Piece, so I gotta use my calipers and determine where my foot needs to be, okay, because I can't go too wide, it's gonna insert into another piece. I also need to be mindful of how thick this is, so I can't trim too much because I risk going through. So I've made a couple of inserts, or made a couple of cuts that kind of keep me guided. So I made a cut here, and then I think that the nice curve is about here, so I've kind of like made these cuts strategic to kind of keep me on track with how much I'm taking off. Okay. days six. It's got a little bit of a...
I went back to the base and I put that back on the wheel, which was really easy to do because I threw it on a bat. So I put that on the wheel again and I kind of trimmed it up and I added a little bit of texture. Give it a little bit of something extra.
You're at an amusement park on the first hill of the biggest roller coaster in the state.
Oh boy.
Your fear of heights was more than enough reason to never get.
This is the final results all put together. And this was a really cool project and I'm really, really glad that I got the opportunity to do this and I saw it through. And I hope I inspired you to maybe make something similar and try something new. Try big. You can do anything.
No.